Carbs aren't healthy. Carbs make you fat. Carbs aren't technically essential. Yet, for some reason, carbohydrate metabolism is literally the first biochemical pathway that I learned about in biochemistry when I was studying chemical and biomolecular engineering at the University of Maryland. But that's none of my business. I guess the mainstream media knows better than the multiple PhD biochemists who wrote my biochemistry textbook. All right, let's get started. If you're new here, my name's Ben Richardson. I am a chemical engineer. I'm also a personal trainer and a certified nutrition coach. For years, I suffered from poor health from being overweight and experienced symptoms like low energy, junk food cravings, social anxiety, poor sleep, and low libido. And it wasn't until I went through a pretty nasty breakup in college that I started to get a grip on my life. So I'm here to share everything I've learned since then with the world through my channel. So if you want to join my little tribe of self-improvers, go ahead and hit the subscribe button because I do post videos just like this one every single week. Carbohydrates. Yes, they are technically non-essential to the body, but that does not mean that they magically unbecome your body's preferred fuel source to drive biological functions. You like that? I just invented a new word, unbecome. YouTube, I want a quarter every single time someone uses the word unbecome.
Call the patent office, copyright the name Green Goblin. I want a quarter every time somebody says it.
Also, if you're exercising at all, to any extent, and you're not eating carbs, you're straight up not fueling your body efficiently. I mean, that's like trying to hunt with a squirt gun instead of a crossbow. It's just such an obvious mistake that it's actually kind of hilarious. And if I haven't triggered you yet with my super controversial statements about carbohydrates that I've provided no scientific evidence of my claims for yet, fructose specifically is literally the best compound on planet Earth that you can consume to fuel your body's health. Fructose is the preferred fuel source of your thyroid gland, and your thyroid gland is responsible for regulating your metabolic rate. Give that sucker what it wants. He's the big chief in charge, folks. You can straight up boost your metabolism by eating more carbohydrates, specifically fructose. Now, let me be very clear about something. Little Debbie Swiss rolls and cosmic brownies are not examples of foods with fructose in them. That crap they put in them's like two molecules away from being the same material your water bottle's made out of. So when I say fructose, I am talking about foods like whole fruits, natural sweeteners like cane sugar, honey, agave, natural maple syrup, sugar from honey, and organic fruit juices. When you fuel your body with what it wants to thrive, you will straight up shift your body from operating in a low energy state into a high energy state where it uses energy to optimize every single biological function that takes place in your body. By the way, if you're enjoying my ramblings about nutrition in this video, you should download my fitness and nutrition app. It's called RichFit. Get it? Because my last name's Richardson. But it's free to download on both the Google and the Apple stores. I do a lot more rambling about nutrition in my free 12-week fat loss program, so make sure you go check that out. But back to fructose. Think about what bears do when they come out of hibernation. They stuff their fat furry faces with what? Honey. And honey has natural fructose in it. Why on earth do they do this? Because they want to ramp up their metabolisms after sitting around doing absolutely nothing for so freaking long. Your metabolic rate is subject to change. You are not cursed with a slow metabolism, and you are not cursed with bad genetics. What you have been cursed with is bad information about nutrition and biochemistry your whole life. Even the dietary guidelines for Americans, which is practically the United States handbook on how to eat healthily, says that a diet that consists of only 35% of your calories coming from carbohydrates, that is considered a low carb diet. Like, dude, you are being bamboozled by the mainstream media that's just trying to convince you of some bullcrap. And you want to know why people buy into it? Because cutting carbs out of your diet can get you fast results. And that's all that people care about, is fast results. Who cares about healthy? Who cares about sustainable? Who cares about realistic? I want it now. I want to become Brad Pitt in like 2 days. I want Kylie Jenner's body in like 1 week. So I get it. I do get it. Let me tell you a little story about a professor named Mark Hobb of Kansas State University. Once upon a time, Dr. Mark Hobb decided to conduct a little experiment to disprove the myth that carbs make you fat. So naturally, he decided to eat nothing but Twinkies and Oreos and cookies, cake and donuts and muffins and ice cream for 10 weeks straight. You know, naturally, if you're gonna disprove a myth, you might as well go a little extreme with things. And guess what happened? Dude lost 27 pounds because he only ate 1,800 calories per day.
You're dead. You crazy son of a bitch, you're dead.
Carbs don't make you fat. Now, that's not exactly how I recommend that you go about losing weight, but if you can pull it off like he did, I mean, knock yourself out, I guess. Also, did you know that from the years 1980 to 2003, obesity rates tripled in the continent of Australia, but sugar consumption dropped by 23%? How on earth did all those people get fat from eating less sugar? It's almost like sugar doesn't actually make people fat. For thousands of years, humans thrived off of foods that are naturally sweet. Remember the promised land from the Bible that God delivered the Israelites to? They referred to the promised land as the land flowing with milk and honey. Carbohydrates are also the most important macronutrient to consume for hormonal health. And testosterone is in fact a hormone. When you restrict carbs, you are signaling to your body that times are rough rather than plentiful. As a result, guess what kind of hormones are going to dominate your system when you restrict carbohydrates? Stress hormones. Maybe you've seen that documentary on Netflix called Game Changers, but you want to know what the biggest takeaway I got from watching that was? It wasn't that vegans outperform meat eaters or anything, it's that athletes who eat more carbohydrates perform better. I mean, that documentary went on and on about how bad animal products are for you and that vegan athletes perform better because they don't eat meat or dairy products. But if you use your brain and look at what actually makes a bigger difference, it's that athletes who eat more carbs perform better. And guess what foods are a staple of any vegan's diet? Whole fruits. So yeah, I mean, if all you're eating is red meat and cheese, then your diet is horrible. But the problem with that documentary is that it just takes that and runs with it. And it moronically concludes that eating animal products is bad for you and that being vegan is good for you. That's a very bad conclusion, but we also have our group of polar opposite extremists who are like, yeah, eating nothing but animal products is good for you because sugar and fructose and carbs all cause inflammation and fat gain. Can we please just stop with all these stupid extreme claims? It is a fact that nutrients in animal products are way more bioavailable for our bodies to use compared to plant-based products. But it is also a fact that our bodies use carbohydrates for fuel very efficiently. It's not a matter for animal-based carnivore diet versus all plant, everything's made out of soy diet. It's a matter of eating a balance of fats, carbs, and protein. But carbohydrates are especially going to help fuel your body to stimulate efficient metabolic functioning. I also want to make a pretty logical point. The mainstream media talks so much about how bad sugar and carbs and fructose are for you, but no one is getting healthier. Obesity rates are continuing to climb, and more people are taking prescription medications to treat symptoms of chronic illnesses. No one is getting healthier. Complex carbohydrates and starchy carbs also get demonized, but I think starchy carbs are some of the most filling carb sources out there. They're incredibly satisfying and they're relatively low in calories usually, especially tubers like carrots and potatoes and beets and onions. If you want to lose weight, start eating a pound of potatoes with your dinner and see how it makes you feel. You probably won't even be able to finish your whole meal because you'll be so stuffed from all those potatoes. And a pound of potatoes only has a few hundred calories in them. Just don't drench them in fat or anything. When I say potatoes, I'm not talking about like french fries or freaking tater tots. I'm talking about baked potatoes or a sweet potato that you throw in the oven. But anyways, with all of that being said, something you might be wondering is how many carbs should you eat? And I'd say that's kind of up to you. I'd recommend at least 40% of your calories coming from carbohydrates. I've personally gone as high as 60% of my calories coming from carbs, and I've experienced nothing but exuberant health and energy from doing that. I also noticed that I build strength a lot easier in the gym when I fill up on carbohydrates too. And I actually credit my high carbohydrate intake for my vascularity. Eating more natural fruits is a great way to boost nitric oxide production, and nitric oxide is your body's primary vasodilator. So increasing how much nitric oxide your body produces, that is going to improve nutrient delivery to all of your body's biological tissues, because your blood is going to be flowing more efficiently throughout your body. And if you want to learn more about how to improve blood flow, make your way on over to this video right up here. I go over 7 tips on how to increase your vascularity. So if you're trying to hop on those veiny arm gains, head on over there once you're done watching this one, and I'll see you over there. But that's all for this video. If you liked it, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here and you've made it this far, I would love it if you subscribe to my channel as well. Also, make sure you download my fitness and nutrition app. It's called RichFit and it's free to download on the Apple and the Google stores. There's a free 12-week fat loss program in there with tons of fitness and nutrition training, so make sure you take advantage of that. If you follow that program to the T, you are going to get some great results. Anyways, if you made it to the end, I do appreciate you sticking around. I hope you got a lot out of this video too. Now go stuff your face full of carbohydrates, because that's what your body wants. But thanks for watching, everyone. Take care, and I'll see you in the next video.